Eamon Fadzi, Profiles of Chamorros, made possible by a grant from the Guam Council on the Arts and Humanities Agency, Government of Guam, Office of the Governor, and the National Endowment for the Arts.
After earning a degree in economics, Richard Flores Taitano returned home and began working as an economist trainee in the Department of Commerce. In 1952, he was named Director of Finance, and his job was to account for all the money spent by the entire government of Guam, including the expenses of the Guam legislature and the salaries of the senators. In the early days of the newly established civilian government of Guam, legislative salaries were paid by the federal government, and much to the discomfort of Dick Taitano, senior statesmen like B.J. Bordalio, Eduardo J. Calvo, Antonio B. Wampat, and others had to report to the young Taitano. When he left for Berea College in Louisville, Kentucky in 1946, he was detained in Honolulu because he did not have a birth certificate, and immigration officials held him for days until the Navy government in Guam verified his origin. Upon his arrival in Louisville, he was instructed to sign up for the draft, and although the postmaster did not know how to list him, Taitano declared himself as an American national and was eventually listed as a foreign student and had to regularly report to the U.S. immigration. While attending the Wharton School of Economics in Philadelphia in 1950, President Truman signed the Organic Act of Guam, and with a stroke of the pen, Taitano and all other Chamorro American nationals became U.S. citizens. He later had to give U.S. immigration officials a copy of the Organic Act to prove he was an American citizen. After working 9 years as Guam's Director of Finance, Taitano was selected by President John F. Kennedy to become the Director of the Department of Interior's Office of Territories in 1961, and marked the first and only time that a native son of Guam held such a high position in the federal government. This post was the forerunner of today's Assistant Interior Secretary for Territorial and Insular Affairs. In 1964, he was named Deputy High Commissioner of the Trust Territory of the Pacific Islands and served until 1966. After serving in the 9th and 10th legislatures, he ran with Ricky Bordalio in Guam's first gubernatorial election. After losing in 1970, Dick was re-elected to the Guam legislature and served in the 11th through the 15th legislatures and retired from politics in 1980.
You have just seen Eamon Fadzi, Profiles of Chamorros, brought to you by the Chamorro Heritage Institute Planning Group and your public television station, KGTF Channel 12.